We're here to connect. Love, time, death. Now these three things connect every single human being on Earth. We long for love. We wish we had more time. And we fear death. Howard, at the beginning of the movie, he's struggling with finding some reason to go on.
Did you lose a child, Howard?
Howard's experience. It's very poignant. It's about someone who's gone through a horrible loss.
Howard is a brilliant, creative, charismatic guy. He used to love life, and now he hates it.
Everybody in the film's been sideswiped, Howard the worst of all. But all the others, they've got their own struggles as well.
I really love you.
Mom says you butcher that word.
Not when I say it to you.
But Howard's struggling with big, deep philosophical questions.
I try to talk to him, I try to reach him, and he's not there. I miss him.
They feel for him so desperately and so deeply, but also are extremely concerned because he's grieving so profoundly.
He writes letters.
Who are they to?
Howard doesn't write letters to people. He writes to things.
Time. Love. Death.
Kids write letters to Santa Claus. It doesn't mean they're crazy.
No, this is therapeutic.
In this process, he's trying to just come back to some understanding and some meaning and some why. So he writes the letters to love, time, and death. And then the unexpected happens.
Who did you write the letter to?
I wrote the letter to death.
Nice to meet you. Charmed, I'm sure.
No.
He has lost his way in the world, but something positive can be found in the most difficult, darkest of circumstances.
You're gonna think I'm crazy.
But I've been having conversations. Death came first. She met me in the dog park.
So death is a her?
Turns out death is an elderly white woman.
I'm time.
I'm abundant. I'm a gift. And you're wasting it.
He was sitting right here.
And he just appeared, right?
I'm love. And I'm the fabric of life. I'm within you. I'm within everything.
And it sort of reminded me of It's a Wonderful Life in a sense that we can all stop and listen and learn something from someone else.
What if love, death, and time are trying to help?
If you open yourself and ask for help, it comes in all sorts of directions.
You need to talk to them, Howard. Reason with them, challenge them, just engage.
I saw you in her eyes when she called me daddy and you betrayed me.
This magical experience turns out to be the path to hopefully living and loving again.
Any movie you make, you draw up your dream cast, and somehow for this movie, we got everybody at the top of our list.
It's an extraordinary thing to be sitting in a scene with all of these sensational actors.
To be able to work with this level of actor, day after day, scene after scene, of going to heaven with this one.
We're all, you know, looking at each other, going, oh my God, they're really good. I better be good as well.
Ed would constantly throw ideas around with me and make suggestions. And actually that sense was very much filtering through the actors, and it was lovely.
As an up-and-coming actor, I learned a lot from everybody on the cast, but seeing Will be himself on set and then jump into character, then they say cut, and he's back to Will. It was incredible.
Everybody was very excited to be creating these characters.
We just try to make it as real as possible so that people can come into our world and hopefully travel with this story with us.
I hope it will be a film that people come out with a sense of engagement in life.
He's reaching out to the cosmos for answers.
We've all got an angel if we only sort of take a moment to think about it, and that's a big theme of this story.
There's so much more at stake here than you even understand. It's been the tradition of A Christmas Carol. It's a reminder of what matters in life.
To love and to have the time and then do it all before you die.
I'm within everything.
If you can accept that, then maybe you get to live again.
Something's starting to happen to you.
The point of this is that you put one foot in front of the other, and one day you can look around and you can feel the sunshine on your face again.
It's the profound connection to everything.
That idea is collateral beauty.
I promise you, it's there.
You here to take me?
No, Howard. I'm here to ride the F train with you.